Video. So in this video we will be looking at how to execute polymorphism, that means method overloading compile time polymorphism in Java. Okay, so for that I will just create a program, okay, using my terminal, and I will simply open this particular program here. Okay, so open poly.java. So here now I am good to go with my program. So let me take the same program that we have discussed in the theory session. Okay, so class poly, okay, here I am creating two methods. So void display, and I am opening the method body. Okay, so when I'm opening this method body, let me write down a print statement, system.out.println. okay, so here I am giving method one, right? So once this is done, now I will write another method with the same name. So this is the second point of method overloading, so void display, and similarly I am using system.out.println. here I am trying to print method two. Okay, so after this, now I will have a main method which will, from where the execution will start. So public static void main and string arguments. Okay, and here I am simply, let me just close down the brackets because always we tend to miss out on the brackets. Okay, so here I will try to create an object of poly is equal to new poly, and now I have created this object. Okay, now when I'm doing this, okay, p display, okay, so what is the value I should get? Now when I'm doing this p dot display, now this display is not sure, the compiler is now basically not sure which particular display it should call, so it should give me an ambiguity error. Now let me save this and execute. Okay, so java c poly dot java, let's see what error does it give. Yes, the error it shows that the method display is already defined in class poly, that means it is showing a redundant call to a particular method, right, to two different methods. Okay, so through this the compiler will get confused. So we have to incorporate the third property of overloading, which is basically I will introduce a different type of argument. So in one method I have included an argument, in the next method I have not included an argument. So what I'll try to do now is, if I am executing this, so let me save this, and now let me compile this. Do I get any error? No, I don't get any error here. Now let me run this java poly. Okay, so now see, my output, okay, JVM is giving me the output as the method 2. Why this is happening? Because in this method there is no argument which has been passed, and I am calling that particular method only. Now what if I want to call this method? Okay, what if I want to call the first method? I simply have to pass a value, let's say I will pass 1 here. Okay, so let me save this and I will compile this again. Okay, now the call should go to the first method and my output should be method 1. Okay, so let's see. Yes, the output which I am getting is method 1. So this is the first point which says that if I am changing the number of arguments, okay, then the changes happen. Okay, now it is not that I can include in one method one argument and I do not have to include in the other method anything. You can always go on increasing the number of arguments or decreasing it as per your convenience. Suppose here I am using int a. Now if I am making this call, now the call will go to method 2. Okay, so let me save this, and again if I am executing this, okay, so what will be my output? Now my output should be method 2, because here I am passing just one argument and here also I am passing the value of the argument as just one. Okay, so when I am running this, sorry, when I am executing this, I am getting a call to method 2. Similarly, now if I want to call method 1, what I have to do? I have to pass 2 arguments here. Okay, now the call to method 2 would be done. Okay, let's see. So method 1 would be is done here. So this one would be satisfying the first point of having the different number of arguments. So I'm using the same name, but both of them are functioning in a different manner. All right, now again, the next point says that we can also achieve overloading by changing the sequence of the arguments. Now suppose in the first method I have the first argument as integer a and the second argument as string b. So in the second method, what I'll do is I will introduce string a here, okay, and integer b here. So when I'm doing this, suppose I want to make a call to the first method. So first method has the first argument as int a and the second argument as in string b. So I'm passing a string value here, and when I'm executing this, I will observe that I'm making a call to the first method. Okay, so hence the method 1 is getting printed because I'm passing 2 arguments here. Now in the second method I have simply interchanged it. So now what I in this to call the second method, what I have to do, I have to simply pass on this argument, these arguments, okay, in a reverse manner. So Java C and this. So method 2 is now called. Okay, so this is the second type of our different arguments which we could incorporate using method overriding. Okay, now talking about the third one. So third one is, if I have different data types, okay, or different types of arguments. So in my previous one I have int a, and in the second one I have string a. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll simply use this particular string value. Okay, and when I'm using a string value as an argument, passing a string value as an argument, my second method would be called because it is capable of capturing the string argument. Okay, so method 2 should be my output. Yes, method 2 I am getting as the output. Okay, so this is how we can achieve method overloading. Now as already discussed in my theory session, will this return type of the methods create any difference? Okay, so let us do it and see. So if I'm introducing int here instead of void, so will it still be okay or will it throw me an error? So let me see. So if I'm doing this, okay, is it showing me an error? Okay, it is missing an argument. It is missing a bracket here. Return. It is showing that it is missing a return statement. Okay, so I'll give here as return 0. All right. Okay, so here now let's compile this. Okay, so sorry. So this is return 0. Okay, now this is fine. So Java C. Now you can see that there is no such error. Okay, let me clear the screen first so that it becomes easy. Okay, now let me compile this program. Okay, so it is not creating any problem. Okay, now let me simply run this program, Java Poly. Okay, so see, my method 2 would be called. That means this particular method would be called. Okay, so because I'm passing a string string as an argument here. Okay, so it is not creating any difference. Apart from that, I have to add this additional statement because it is having a return type of int, but we do not have to worry about the other functionality because it is already, this particular method is getting called using this method call. Okay, even if I'm changing the value, even if I'm changing the return type. Okay, so this is how your method overloading or compile time polymorphism takes place. Okay, we will discuss on further on this, and we also have to discuss another concept, which is, can we actually overload the main method? So we will see this in my next video, and also some associated concepts related to method overloading. Okay, and this is known as compile time polymorphism. Okay, so this is all for this video. We will again talk in details about this in next video. Thank you.